Diehard Swifties travelling from interstate to see Taylor Swift in Melbourne have descended on our studios, but they have also been left in the lurch after finding their Airbnb bookings cancelled just days before the concert. The real kicker, though, is that the same fans are seeing their Airbnbs relisted for even more cash. They're now being left with trying to find alternative accommodation in a city that appears to be booked out.
We are joined now by Swiftie Lily, who found herself with that exact problem. Lily, talk us through what happened with your Airbnb booking.
Yeah, so about 8 months ago, I was lucky enough to book an Airbnb for a pretty reasonable price, until 3 days ago he decided to let me know that he had to cancel it as he had an emergency renovation.
Okay, so that sounds kind of legit. What happened next?
So then I questioned him on it and asked him, well, that sounds like something you would have known 3 days prior to 3 days before my stay. There was a bit of a language barrier, so he couldn't really give me an answer. And I questioned him, asked him when I'd get my refund, and he couldn't really tell me what was going on. And I said, well, can you provide me with some evidence? And he couldn't even do that. So I said, well, all right, I'm going to take this up with Airbnb because it's just not good enough. So I paid about $900 for my 4-night stay in Brunswick. I then decided to check if the listing was still up, because it shouldn't be. The listing was then up for just over $2,000, so he made double over what he would have made from me. So good on him.
Lily, I don't think that's a good on him situation. What's Airbnb's response been?
Oh, Airbnb was lovely enough to give me a $47 credit to cover a stay somewhere else over the weekend, which could maybe get me a hostel if I'm lucky. But now we're staying here, and Airbnb said he let you know in a timely manner, so there's not much we can do. And I'm not sure what timely manner they're running on, but it's not the same as mine.
So did you offer maybe to help him with his emergency repair? Perhaps you could have stepped in, fixed it, solved the problem.
And gotten back in there all in time for the show.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying, but I don't know, maybe he was a little Swiftie, he needed the place for himself, and fair enough, maybe I'll catch him at the concert tomorrow.
You do seem to have some sort of place. Are you okay?
Yeah, so we were lucky enough to get this really nice 4-star hotel in the heart of the city, so it's definitely the flowers after the rain, which is lovely. I think it's a much nicer place than what we booked. Even though it is more expensive, we get a sauna now, so he can keep his Airbnb. We've got a sauna.
Things aren't all too bad. What Taylor song would best sum up your feelings towards your former host?
I think my Taylor Swift song for this moment would be The Man, because I am so sick of running as fast as I can to get things that I'm happy for. And I think this man is just trying to capitalise off the fact that Taylor Swift fans are young teenage girls and they're easier to walk over, in his opinion.
Lily, you can't see me, but I'm in my man blazer right now.
Oh, is that what that is?
Love
to see it.
Yeah, you can visualise. And before I let you go, I am obsessed with all of your bracelets. If you can, what's your favourite one that you are adorning right now? Like, which is your favourite?
Okay. My favourite one, I don't think I can say on here, but there's a few others. Honestly, I think my favourite one, my friend Mia made it for me, and it says Swift, but it's spelt wrong, so it says Swift. So,
well, I'm glad. I hope
you got the Swift bracelet.
You'll be glad to know, Lily, that Tony has his friendship bracelet on as well right now. All Too Well,
all
you know.
All Too Well, baby. What's going on?
Oh, best song. Great song.
Lily, thank you so much for speaking with us. Enjoy the concert.
Thank you.